What's up, y'all? This is Hussein Nasser from iGeometry, and happy holiday. I hope you had a wonderful holiday. And today we want to discuss this. Today's vlog is about persistent connections. So I know this is probably not the topics you want to hear about after a beautiful holiday, but yeah, that's the channel you're following. It's about software engineering, so bear with me. So yeah, I want to discuss persisted connections. So what is this concept? What is a persistent connection, and why was it invented to begin with? So a connection is a logical channel between a server and a client. And ever since networking was invented, the connections was basically, it's very essential. It's basically the TCP connection, to be exact, was invented for these reasons. So let's go back to the HTTP first, HTTP 1.0. So the first version of HTTP says, okay, I want to open a connection. I am a client, I am the browser, and I want to open a connection to a server, to a web server, say Google. So what I want to do is opening a connection. Well, okay, I just visited google.com. That will open a connection, says, hey, I want to retrieve that the page load of the google.com, right? And then Google responds, which says, hey, okay, I saw your request, so let me send you the packet. And then once that packet received, the connection is closed, right? And then imagine, like, you received all these HTML code in your client. Then you have a bunch of other stuff in your resources in the HTML, right? Images, code, stuff, and other URLs. And now, especially images, like if you have especially a page like National Geographic with a lot of images, and then now each image is another URL, is another page that you have to visit. So let's open another connection and make that request to that server, which is wherever it lives, right? Now, once you open that connection, what you're gonna do is, all right, retrieve, and then close it again. And this used to happen for every single resource in your page, right? And we're speaking now in the terms of web pages, but we're gonna get to the databases stuff that we're interested in. All right, so yeah. So now imagine each resource is doing that. Oh, close, open, close, open, close, open, close, open. For every single resource, that turned out to be, and the reason HTTP 1.0 was closing every connection, because it said, hey, let's save memory. I'm done sending, let's close memory. So it makes sense, right? Open a connection, do your work, close the connection. Open a connection, do your work, close the connection. So it's like, okay, that seems to be the logical thing to do back when the HTTP 1.0 was invented, the first protocol. But it was very problematic because it was causing a lot of congestion in the network. And not only that, it was also causing slow performance, because most of the time spent loading a page was just closing and opening a connection. That was like, ooh, it's a lot, right? So then they invented the concept of persistent connections, which is what the name indicates, right? So just open a connection, and as long as you are sending stuff through this channel, just keep it alive. And there is a header called keep alive, right? And that's really interesting. So yeah, so just open a connection, keep it alive at the server, keep it alive at the client, send all the stuff you want, send all the stuff back and forth. Then once you're done, really done this time, just go ahead and close it. All right. So that sped up things real well, because oh yeah, I don't spend time now closing and opening, because TCP in general, because HTTP is just TCP at the back end, right? So I don't spend time opening and closing. This is called a slow startup, I think. I forgot the term. But a slow startup or slow start, I think. So that the slow start itself is a mechanism that it is a congestion traffic mechanism in TCP that prevents congestion, network congestion. So TCP is slow to start to begin with. So closing and opening is slow. So now I have a persistent connection. Does that have any disadvantages? We'll come to that. But now let's pause that for a second and then come back to our programming paradigm. If you're a software engineer, if you're a programmer, well, you know, right? You know that you've written a lot of code, you have a client, you have a desktop application, and then you have a database, and you want to query that database. So you're always left with this question. So I have a connection. Should I open and close the connection, or should I leave the connection open and send all my stuff? So based on this, what we learned today, you should leave the connection open. But, so what is the cost of this? Leaving connections open. What do you think, guys? Right? So, leaving connections open obviously will take memory, right? So, leaving connections open, especially with large number of connections, like we're talking about millions, right? So, that will basically eat up your service, your server connections, like, because I'm leaving these connections open. And as long as you don't need them, go close them. So you have to be smart about this. So even if I have a lot of connections open, if this is a connection that is not used for a certain time, maybe you want to close it. So you have to think about resources as well. So this video is running about 8 minutes, and I need to wrap up now. But yeah, just one last thing. So back to the HTTP example, and this is really interesting. And then the invention of the denial of service attack is because, I believe, of this new HTTP, which is HTTP 1.1, persisted connections. So now that I'm leaving connection open, those attackers says, hey, let me send a connection request to the server, and then I'm gonna deny him of the rest of the request. So I'm not gonna send an acknowledgement that, hey, I received your request, but it says, hey, open a connection, but don't do anything. And then send another request from another server, open a connection, but don't do anything. Keep those connections open. And so do this on a larger scale, and your servers are done. That's what happened to Yahoo a few years ago, right? So that's just a very interesting thing. Persisted connections, keep it in mind. And happy holidays, guys. Stay awesome.